This is part 5 of the Painting Baby Yoda tutorial. We're almost done. If you've missed the other parts, 1 through 4, be sure to check the link in the description. All right, let's get going. Okay, first I'd just like to say thank you to all of you who made it this far. You're doing great, and I hope you finish this project. And also thank you to all those who have been downloading from my Gumroad page. I really appreciate it. So hopefully you are learning something, and the little bit of knowledge I have is helping you. So thank you very much. So let's get going. So now we're going to add a new layer. And now we're going to use our favorite paintbrush, the watercolor paintbrush. Now we're going to use black. Just black. Not the dark blue, just the black. And we are going to do the darkest parts of his eyes, which is most of it, and the darker areas in the creases of his eyelids and his mouth and a little bit under his nose, and finish up by doing all the darkest areas of his clothing. Now you can take the wash brush and just smooth out those lines you just created. Okay, now we're going to merge that layer with the one underneath it. And actually we can merge the clothing layer with the one, the final layer underneath. And now we're going to add a new layer. And we're going to pick kind of this bright orange color that you see in his ears. Well, I do have this one already in my palette I could use. You know, that's actually pretty close. So if you want to follow where this circle is right here, it's kind of not quite to red. And this one is not quite all the way to fully saturated. Just maybe we do want it fully. Nah, probably not. Almost. And then you can drag that down into your palette from up here. I think I will just steal that in case it's a little different. And go to our new layer. Zoom in again. Make sure it's not too big. Okay, so we're just going to cover this up here. Probably have to do something to make it a little bit darker. We'll do a darker version of this color in these areas. We might need to clean it up too. I'm going to bring the flow down. That's better. I'm going to start over. Actually, I'm going to hit undo. I brought the flow down to about 15 or 14, somewhere in there. Now I'm going to do that. Yeah, that's better. I'm going to make my brush just a tiny bit bigger. All right, now we're going to take our favorite blending brush again. And we're just going to blend this out, but don't blend it up into the green area. You can help it. So I'm thinking maybe that same blue. Or, because you could just go darker with this shade. But that might start to look a little too brown. Let's add a new layer and just play with that and see what we get. And just do that in the areas where it actually is darker. Oh, well, that's working okay. We could do that. Blue would also probably work. Let's really utilize our layers here. So we got that in there. Let's add one more layer. Save this color. And now pick your navy blue that you probably still have from before. Let's turn this one off so we don't see it. And make sure you're working on the correct layer, the new one. And just see what happens when you bring this in. I'm going to go back to the brown layer, find my brown color, and just kind of fill in. It's not doing anything. Is it? It is doing something. This one you can't see over the blue as much. It's very translucent, but it'll blend. We'll blend it all together. Oops. I didn't lift my brush, so when I undid that, it took away a lot. Okay. While we're here, I'm gonna check this. Yeah, take that same dark brown, reddish, rusty color and do by his nail here. Just inside here, because his nail has kind of a brownish tint to it, and we want that to show up. I don't think there's any on the other side. Now, I think what we can also do is while we have this color selected, let's make his robes a little bit more interesting. We're gonna go back. Oops. Did weird things. Okay, we're gonna go and pick this chalk pastel that still has our bumpy pattern on it. And we're just going to go along the edges between the darks and make it bigger. So undo bigger. Just kind of, because there's like almost this little bit of a glow that happens in here. Same way we just did this one, and then blend it out and do it on a new layer so you don't have to worry about it messing with anything. I'm blending these out quite a bit actually, but you can still see it. See, that adds something there. Just needed some color. It's still kind of bland looking to me. This is the brown color again, so you're not seeing much, but this one you should see here. Now I'm blending the dark blue, so I went to that layer. And that's the one you really want to blend because you can really see those shapes. Okay, hey, it's looking like something. We are getting close to the final. Yeah, I really wanted to say final countdown. No. No, I won't do it. But I did it. Okay, so let's merge these. So this one, and then this one, and then into the main picture, like that. Okay, now we get to do the fun part. All of it should technically be fun, otherwise why are you doing this? So this will be the painting with the light part that I just love doing. It's my favorite part. We're gonna add a new layer. Go up to your regular brush again, watercolor brush. Now we're going to pick a color that resembles this lightest highlight. It's kind of a yellowy color. But it has a little bit, some areas have kind of an orangey glow, some have more of a yellow, lemon yellow kind of glow. So we're going to bring this up really close to, we're going to go right in the middle. Not quite orange, not quite yellow. Nice sunlight glow kind of color. Not all the way to the white, you want to be just underneath it. And now on this layer, right now where it says blending, right here, it's on normal. We want to come and select soft glow. Now that's going to be like painting with light. Now to really see it, if you want, you can go down here to your bottom most layer. It's the background layer. And let's just choose a darker color, like a dark blue. I like to do that a lot of times, even if it's not going to stay that color, just to give myself something a little less bright to stare at, but it also helps see your edges and things a lot better. Okay, so let's start up at his head here. You don't want too big of a brush. The flow up a little bit. And we're just going to, don't worry about the hair shapes just yet. We're going to fill this area in. See how bright that is? And it is almost white, that's why you don't want it to be white. In fact, we could even darken this a little bit more. But we will be blending it, so and we'll let some of what's underneath shine through. So we're just going to kind of cover this area for now. Don't worry about the hair. We're just going to get what this is in here first. You can be a little bit hairy-like shapes. Let's make this smaller so we can really do that. Over the top of these wrinkles that are up here, where you can still see some of the dark, but the hair overlaps. Same thing. Go under here and just kind of get these shapes in. All right, so now what we're going to do, we're going to do some lighter touches of the same color. We can bring down the flow just a bit more, about 15. Make your brush bigger. We're going to do this area at the bottom of his ear. We'll be blending it out, so don't worry about the line. We just want that to show a bit. Make it have that glow because it's catching some light. Now we're going to do some highlight areas on his head. So let's see, we're going to do just under the eye or above the eyelid here, the top of the eyelid. Just enough there. Just to accentuate some of these. Because this is becoming, I'm going to make it smaller, this is becoming reflected light again. Do by his nose, and you don't have to be heavy-handed here because it's not super bright and we will be blending it. So these are just accentuating the bumps and ridges. Alright, so now we are going to blend this. Let's blend the really bright stuff first. And you're not blending a ton, you're just going to keep the edges kind of sharp. Okay, now we can pick another new layer. This one will also be soft glow. And we're gonna go with a slightly different color. We're gonna go with a bluer color. Now we don't want it too bright because it'll just show up as white. But we do want kind of this cloud blue. So I got that already in there. I'm just gonna start with it and so kind of a medium, right in the middle here in the blue area, and kind of a little bit grayer, about right here. It'll turn out, you know, really bright. So now we're gonna do his eyes and then part of his outfit. So we're going to make sure our brush is small. I'm gonna be a lot harder with it where it's really bright, not quite so much as it fades out. Get these little dots in there. I'm going to up the flow a bit and make this smaller. There, and then up here, and especially right here. I'm also going to just put a little bit of something here just to bring that. We'll blend it out when we get there again. Okay, same thing on the other eye. So that really, we're going to blend it, but it really makes his eyes look more realistic. Okay, now we're going to come across. I'm just gonna bring this one out a tiny bit more. It doesn't matter that it's not the same color because it's almost white anyway. A couple of these that got blended too much. Now we're gonna start putting in the hairs. So you want a real small brush and you just wanna pull away. Draw them in there and pull your hand away as you're getting them across here. Just keep doing that. They don't have to all go exactly the same because some of them are sticking out more. And some of these are smaller because only partial catching the light. Go over some of your other lines and they help define each other. Now, don't worry that, see, part of the reason this doesn't show up very good right here is there's nothing underneath it, and there will be eventually. So, because this is very translucent and it needs kind of something else to give it something to stick to, I guess you could say. That's why having those flat colors in there underneath your painting is really important, especially when you get to doing this part. So this area that we just kind of colored in, bring some of these shapes in to kind of help blend that. This is a little bit more tedious work, but it makes a difference to take the time to do it. And that John Wick drawing illustration I did to do this for his beard all over in different colors. So I had to do it multiple times. But in the end, it looks great. So just ignore your boredom and do it. Put on some good music when you can. That helps take your mind off of the boring parts. I'm going to add a new layer, and this time it's not going to have soft glow on it. And we're just going to draw this in a little bit up here just to give that little blue tint. I mean, you probably could do this, but you'd have to make the color darker and then use the soft glow. And then it'll kind of give more of this color to it. Okay, blending brush. Blend that out a bit so it isn't quite so harsh. Let's go back to the soft glow layer beneath it. And we'll just kind of lightly go over our hairs that we put here, just very lightly. Just to kind of, so they're not sharp, too sharp looking. Even the ones across the top. I'm going to go down now to the very bottom layer. We're gonna make sure this isn't too big. And we're just gonna go across this top edge here and just soften it across the ear, especially in the head. Just to make it go back and have a little bit of a glow underneath it too, because when such bright light is kind of bouncing off of somebody's head or whatever like this, it softens the edge because your eye has trouble really seeing it. Yeah, that's better. In fact, you can even turn this off to see it better. But I'll even do this here, even though we're going to be covering that. It gives kind of a smoky atmospheric look behind them here. Turn those back on. All right, now we're gonna go back to that soft glow layer. It's the top one. And we're gonna make sure our brush is small, and we're gonna blend a little bit of these really bright Here he is on his eyes. Make sure you're not over blending though. Just kind of blurring out the edges of them. All right, I think that's starting to look like Baby Yoda. This has been part 5 of the How to Paint Baby Yoda tutorial. Be sure to join me for the last part, part 6, as we add in some of the background. If you are enjoying this tutorial, please be sure to hit that like button and subscribe so you don't miss any more. Thanks for watching!